the prophetic lineage of Jesus Christ. This is 77 generations. In the Hebrew names of all of these people that you see in this list, they all have Hebrew meaning. That's the amazing thing about the Hebrew naming system, is they're like sentences. They'll say something. So what I did is I basically said, this lineage is a picture of Jesus. That's what it is. He is the seed. I did it two ways. From Adam, through David, through Solomon, down through Joseph to Jesus. And then I did Adam, through David, over to Nathan, and down through Mary to Jesus. I would like you to just listen. Behold the power of our God. This is extraordinary. He will be the last Adam, standing redemptively in the place of another. The people of this earth are his possession, and for the praise of God, he has come down to make a way. When he dies, there will be an outpouring. His death will be as a weapon. He is brought low that he may prove powerful. He will bring rest and will be a resting place. His name will be famous among those who have been cut off from the breast and bound in the enemy's stronghold. For he calls them his possession. He will enter this earth as a tender shoot, as one from the heavenly region. He will divide even the closest friends. He will be a branch burning with resolve when he takes up residence here. He will be the father of a multitude, the chief of a mighty host. He laughs at the deceiver and supplanter and overcomes. He shall be praised, and the breach he will fortify and close and wall in. He is exalted, the royal seed who will crush the head of the hissing enchanter. So now let's go down to the royal lineage. This is through David, down through Solomon, through Joseph, and to Jesus. He will be a covering of garments, and in him is strength. He will come serving to make wealthy his beloved and bring peace and enlarge for himself a people. He will say, Jehovah is my father. He will be harmed but then healed, hurt but then made whole. It will be said that he, God, has judged, and he, God, is exalted. He will prove the strength of God and the perfection of God. He will possess in his hand the power of God, and though he is forgotten of his people, he will prove the master builder and divinely heal them. And he, God, will set and make strong those who ask of God, those born in captivity. He will say, my father is majesty. He will be raised up by God to be a helper, to be the righteous one. God will raise him up for God's praise, majesty, and splendor. He will be the help of God, a gift. And to the heel-grabbing supplanter, he will exchange out life for death and bring God's salvation. The blood lineage. This is Nathan down through Mary and then to Jesus. He will be a covering of garment, and in his strength he will come serving to make wealthy his beloved and give the gift of God. He declares to those under the enchantment that they are his dearest object of care and that he will raise them up. He will be the giver of grace, life in exchange for death. They will praise God who hearken unto him and join to him in covenant. Those who receive the gift of God, the one whom God has exalted, will find the help and salvation of God. They will be sustained by God, be quickened, made awake, and made alive. He will be measured according to the king's divine oracles. He will be adorned as king. He will be a heavenly light unto all who ask of God, and those born in captivity he will heal and give grace. He shall be praised, for he gives life in exchange for death. To those who hearken the good tidings, he gives the gift of God unto the small. He is the bright light unto those whose eyes are fixed on God, and he is a consolation and comfort unto the burdened. The gift of God is life in exchange for death. It's the violent action of the king in order to join in covenant. The gift of God raises us to heavenly heights and gives life and liberty in exchange for death and rebellion, and brings us God's salvation. Lineage of majesty. Mary's name means rebellious. Where will the seed of God be born? It'll be born in a woman whose name is rebellious. This is amazing. Eve, she rebelled. She ate of the fruit. She turned against the word of God and she rebelled. What does Mary do? Mary is the true woman whom the seed of God rebellious. And yet God in this whole thing rectifies that which was wrong in the garden. He uses a woman and corrects it all. We are the bride of Christ. Be it unto me according to thy will. And we turn and believe. And then the life of God is born in us, in the rebellious. And there is redemption that is brought. And that which comes forth out of the rebellious is pure and holy and righteous. He is taking that which went wrong, and he is restoring it in and through the womb of a woman. And by the way, we are to be that virgin in which the life of Christ is born afresh. We are to be the habitation of God through which the seed, the fruition of God, comes forth into this earth. Yes, we are the rebellious. But we have the privilege of giving rise and life to the Messiah and saying, I, the rebellious, need what you, the perfect, have done to restore and to rectify and to redeem that which the enemy has destroyed. I turn to you. I want us to stand back in awe and wonder at the majesty of our God. Yes, it's impossible, but he loves the impossible. And he has done the impossible all over again. In and through us.